Hi everyone and welcome back. Mindy here today for Pretty Pink Posh, and I'm going to be showing you how I created this really fun scene for the Cuddly Cutes stamp set, and I'll be going through some Copic coloring. Here is a look at the stamp set that I'll be using. This is called Cuddly Cats, and it has 6 cat images on there that you can use. I'm only going to be using 2 of them. So I'm using this really sweet cat that looks like it's walking, and then I'll have another one here that will be sitting down. I'm going to stamp these out on Nina Solar Weight cardstock, 80 pound, and I'm using my Mini Misty tool to do that just because I feel safer stamping with a Misty tool in case my ink lines aren't black enough. I'm stamping with the Amalgam ink from Gina K Designs. This is Copic friendly, so I can color with my Copic markers. And I'm just going to close the lid of my door and stamp those down. And this is just a habit of mine, as I stamp them twice because I do like a really nice crisp black line. So I did go ahead, stamp those twice, give them a nice push. And then I can get into the Copic coloring of the cats. So I decided to go with some warm grays. I left a little part of the video here in real time. And what I'm doing is adding in the shadow areas of my first cat, and I'm using the W4. So I added a little bit of a shadow on the back of the cat, on the inside part of the tail, a little bit on the top of the head, a little bit there on the underside of the belly and kind of where that one leg connects. And then I'm also adding shadow areas to the legs that are tucked in the back there. So a little bit of shadow area on the top of that, and then on the back side of the legs. I'm coloring this as my light source would be coming from the right hand side. So now I'm speeding this up, and what I'm doing is blending these out. So I have a W3 is my next color, and I'm just going back over those lines that I had added and blending it out just a little bit further. Then I'll come in with a W2, and once again I'm going back over both of those lines and blending it out just a little bit more. Typically when I'm Copic coloring, I do go over my images twice, so I'm not as concerned with how this first layer looks. I'm just kind of getting a base down on where the shadows are going to go. Now some people like to map out their shadow areas with a lighter marker. I'm more of a person where I just jump right in with my darkest, and I can always add more shadows in later if I feel like I didn't add enough. And when I'm coloring over that darkest marker with, let's say, a W0 or even the W3, it's going to lighten it up a little bit, which is perfectly fine, because if it was too dark to begin with, it'll lighten that up. And I can always darken them, which I really do like my shadow areas. I like to have nice deep shadow areas, because to me that just really gives a lot of contrast. And the final color that's in there is a W0, which really helps lighten up the kind of middle part of the cat, or where the light would be shining. So on this second one, I'm adding the shadow areas to the right hand side, because I know they're going to be looking at each other. And to each their own, you can choose whichever side or however you want to add your shadow areas, or where do you want your light source. You don't even have to color with a light source if you don't want. My personal opinion is I just really like to have that contrast. So maybe the light source isn't in the right direction, or your shadow isn't in the right spot. To me, I'm not as concerned about it. I just want to show definition so that my cats don't look like a flat coloring book image. I wanted it to have a little bit of character to it. You could also add spots to your cats, or if you wanted to color them gray or black or orange, add some stripes for a tabby cat. I'm just keeping these a really simple kind of one blend, not one blend, but one color. And I did add a little bit of pink to the ears and the cheeks. For the background, I'm going to be using some Bristol Smooth cardstock so I can do some ink blending. And that was just a look at the stencil that I'll be using. Before I work on my stencil, I want to create the back layer of a brick wall. So I'm using Hickory Smoke Distress Oxide. That's going to be kind of the cement portion of my brick wall, the gray cement. And I'm using a 2-inch piece of masking. That's post-it tape, actually. It's a 2-inch roll that I have. And I'm just masking off the top portion of what my wall is going to be. So the top half is going to be my sky. The bottom half will be my brick wall. And I'm just coming in and adding that hickory smoke distress oxide. And you can see with Bristol Smooth cardstock, this blends really, really well. It stays wet a little longer, so you want to be careful with your fingers and not get it in the ink because it will smudge it. So I have my first layer down of my brick wall. And I'm going to bring in aged mahogany with my brick wall stencil. And I'm just placing this right over the top while I still have that top area masked off. And I'm going to hold that down with some purple tape just right onto my glass mat here. That way nothing is going to move. And then I can come in with that aged mahogany distress oxide ink and I'm going to go right over the top. So that's going to give me my colored bricks. And when I remove it, it'll look like a, you know, how a brick wall, so it has a cement look behind it. And I'm just carefully and lightly going over that so my stencil doesn't move or shift. And you can make this as dark or as light as you want. You wouldn't even have to add that hickory smoke if you don't want to. Just depends on the look that you're going for. I was picturing the cats walking along a brick wall at night, so that was the look I was going for. And then once that's done, I can go ahead and remove my stencil and my masking tape. So this is looking really cool right now. I'm loving that brick wall. I probably did a little bit too much because I don't show a lot of it, but I'd rather have more than not enough. So I'm also reusing that post-it tape and I'm adding it to the bottom portion. Now it didn't want to stick really well because, like I said, the oxides stay wet just a little bit longer. So I just folded those around the edges to help make that post-it stick. And then I can work on creating my night sky. So I'm bringing in wilted violet. And I'm adding that right at the line there of where the brick wall would be, or right above the line of the brick wall. Then I can come in with some blueprint sketch, add that towards the top, and I'm going all the way to the top because I will be coming in with black soot, and I wanted to kind of have a dark layer there already. And I'll come back in, blend out a little bit more with that wilted violet. And then bringing in the black soot to kind of finish off the night sky look. So if you have an idea where you want to die cut out your shape, that also helps. I knew mine would kind of be off on the right side corner, so I want to make sure I'm leaving all three of those colors visible there. Then I can remove that post-it tape and I have this great sky. Now you could splatter this with water since distress oxide does react with water, but I'm leaving it just as is. This is the stitched stars die from Pretty Pink Posh. And I'm using a piece of 4 1/4 by 5 1/2 inch white cardstock that I'm going to die cut this from. And I'm leaving some overhang. I'll just hold this in place with some purple tape to make sure that doesn't move and it's positioned exactly where I want it to be. And that is going to be the front panel of our card. So I did also go ahead and die cut the cuddly cats out with their coordinating die. And I'm just lining up where my brick wall is going to be. You can see it was a little bit too high. So I'll fix that here in just a little bit before I attach anything. I want to get my sentiment on the front of my card. So I'm using the stamp set Simple Sayings Life. This has a really cute sentiment on here that says, "You make life fun." And I thought that was just a really nice general sentiment. So this could be a Halloween card, "You make life fun," or it could be just because. It doesn't necessarily have to have a purpose. So to me, it's a very versatile stamp set. And I'm just laying that front panel down in my Mini Misty. And this is a trick I had found watching some other YouTube channels as I'm taking a piece of, this is actually a card protector pocket that I have. You could use acetate, you could use, you know, anything clear like this. And this is helping me figure out if this is going to be straight. I love the sentiments from Pretty Pink Posh, but sometimes with these cursive sentiments like that, it's hard to see if they're straight, even with the grid lines. So this, I can stamp it on that plastic, and I'll have a good idea of if it's straight, if I need to adjust it. Now here, I kind of thought I needed to adjust it. And this is the great part. You just wipe it away. So I wanted to straighten that out just a little bit more. So I'm redoing that sentiment, lining that back up in the corner. And then I'm going to give this another practice run before I stamp on my actual card. And I really apologize for the shaking. The way my camera mount is, it's really hard to not shake the table. So I apologize for that little bit of shaking you're seeing. So I'm really happy with how that is stamped out now. So I'm going to wipe this clean, and I feel good about going right to my card now. I think that's pretty straight. And I was actually going off of the first line of the sentiment as kind of what I was eyeballing, what was straight. And then I can just stamp that down. And of course, double stamp because I like my nice bold black lines. So my front panel is done. And now I need to fix my ink blended panel. So you can see that this is a little bit too long, and I'm going to actually trim off that bottom portion just so that my brick wall is lined up in that window where I want it to be. So I'm just cutting about a half inch or so off of that. And then that's going to line up nicely. I'm going with the bottom of the card. That's how I'm going to line it up. Now, what I want to do is I wanted to give this card some dimension. So I'm going to go around the entire back of that front panel and line it with some foam tape. So I'm just trimming a bunch of pieces down, and I'm going to get all those nooks and crannies lined up with the foam tape. Since my ink blended panel is shorter, I'm going to take another piece of white cardstock that measures 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. So that way my foam tape has coverage everywhere to stick to. So I'm just taking the ink blended panel and adding that right to that white base. So once that's attached, I can go ahead and add my front panel, which has all the foam tape on it. So I'll just remove all the backing of my foam tape and add it directly to the top of that card. Now, when I'm adding this, I am not going to push down real hard. I want to add my kitties in there, so I want to be able to tuck them in. So I'm just going to gently lay this down and not really push hard on that yet. So you can see I'm able to kind of lift that up a little bit to be able to tuck my kitties in there, so it looks like they're coming from the other side of the wall. And my second kitty I can tuck in there too. So once I'm happy with that and I know they're going to slide in there, I'm going to go ahead and add this with some Lawn Fawn liquid glue, and I like to use my tweezers because that just helps me maneuver them a little bit better. It keeps my fingers out of the way. And on the second cat, most of the cat is going to be tucked behind, except for the tail I left popped out. I thought that would just be really cute that tail is hanging out like that. So I'll just give that a good push down, make sure those are stuck down really good. And we are just about finished. My last touch is adding these metallic gold jewels. These are so gorgeous. It does look like there's two colors in here, so you really could use either side. But I'm going with the gold side, so my jewel is kind of facing up. And I'm just placing those around my sentiment. I thought this kind of looked like stars around the card. And I'm just using the jewel picker and some liquid glue to get those attached. And that is going to finish up the card for today. So I really hope you enjoyed it. And be sure to head over to Pretty Pink Posh to pick up your cuddly cats and the stitched stars die. Thank you.